So hopefully my test will ring true and this should be working right now. But like always, when I use this setup, it's a little hard for me to see what's way out here in front of me. So please pardon me if I read something poorly or I get flustered a little bit. So this white dwarf was one of the ones that were delayed in the United States. I actually think I'm going to try a little soft speaking with these microphones because they tend to be on the quiet side. So I will kind of loudly whisper or speak softly. For that, I've been kind of struggling with, I guess, some mental health stuff related to, I'm a teacher, I'm going back to school in the next 2 or 3 weeks. My summer is starting to wind down, and I've just kind of been feeling unmotivated. Let's get into this issue. Also, there's been a lot of Gamesworkshop controversy lately, hasn't there? Well, if you are one of the new initiates into BattleTech, you'll be happy to know that heavily clicked BattleTech, and we were highly invested in the Catalyst Games Kickstarter a couple years back. We have lots and lots of mechs. My husband has painted up all of his, and I of course have not, but you know what, it'll be very easy, and I might even do some of my of freebies stuck to this one. So let's see if I can read this contact. Star letter. More Dome Keepers, please. You guys are absolutely blowing it away with your homebrew chapter, The Dome Keepers. Keep it up. The reach back into the deep lore, the beast arises. The fourth bounding is awesome. Maximus Thane. I have a small request, though. I would love to create a Tomekeeper's force based on the characters and lore. But I'm not good with freehand painting. The love that you have put into this chapter deserves a special transfer sheet. What are the chances there will be a Tomekeeper's transfer sheet in the future? As a US-based subscriber for many years, it bummed me out that I couldn't get the Silver Templar's codex and transfer sheet through Conquest. Was such a cool project and one that I see echoes of here. Please consider making a transfer sheet and mini codex for the Dome Keepers. Love what you are doing. White Dwarf has really never been better. And that is from Dave Dennett from Williamsburg, Virginia, here in the US. I love the idea of the mini codex. Oh man, that would be adorable. Maybe they will. Really happy that you like what we've been doing with the Tomekeepers, Dave. Thank you for your kind words. Your letter comes at a fortuitous time because this issue features loads of new Tomekeepers goodies, including new crusade rules, a short story with insights into writing about the chapter, a name generator, and here's the best bit, a transfer sheet. Now you and hopefully many other hobbyists out there in the real world can create your very own Tomekeeper's strike force. Make sure you send us some pictures when you get them painted. Alright, we have that right here. It was one of those issues where it came kind of like in a giant envelope and it had the freebie inside. So you can see we have all sorts of cool tomes. Bigger ones. We have, of course, our arrows and other symbols, our numbers, and other markings that you would need if you were going to make a Tomekeeper's force. Do you guys use a lot of transfers? I really have never put them on. The same idea applies to like the old like temporary tattoos, right? It's a very similar idea, but my husband's really good at putting them on. He gets them on nice and straight. If you are afraid to use them, just I would suggest to get some of the, oh gosh, what is it called? There's a couple of different solutions. One makes it softer. I think, man, I'm gonna have to figure out what that's called. Somebody in the comments can help me out. But there's a couple of, like, chemical solutions you can put in there to make it even better and smoother and clearer and nicer. Because if you don't do anything, sometimes you can see, like, there's, like, an outline around the shape that is, like, transparent. We did get some transfer sheets from the Green Stuff World Order too. Maybe I should make a video about that right after this one. I actually think that would be a good idea. There was another freebie too, which you probably saw in the thumbnail. If the thumbnail is what I'm planning on doing. So this is a poster for the Dark Tide game. We have our grizzled cool. new flavor, at least to me, of bubbly sparkling water, some coconut, pineapple. It's actually really good. Ayo. Okay. Also, I apologize if you hear my hair, like, brushing against the foam head. I still haven't named him. I had a couple of good ideas. Issue at all yet, apart from the cover. Look at this gorgeous Skellinar. Oh my gosh. And that base. Whoa.
This is gorgeous. Okay, I play Luminous Realm Lords. I haven't painted a single thing for them yet. My philosophy with what I choose to paint is I'm going with easy stuff first.
Have some primed up Stormcast Eternals. I'm gonna get my confidence up more and more with that easy stuff and then move on to some more complicated things.
So this is definitely not one that I want to tackle right away. So obviously they've taken Teclis off. He mounts kind of up here. And he's making kind of a Superman pose.
Is anybody into the Chilluminati podcast? My husband and I love listening to those, and whenever I see a T-posing kind of pose, I think of their Mothman episode. The Mothman just stands there with his wings spread out, going, wings out, going,
yeah. Okay, so model of the month, I'm not surprised. This is gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. I love it. Very cool. I'm not totally sure how I want to paint mine when I finally get to them. I have time, let's face it. Green Stuff World, of course, right after. Weeks after we had placed an order, they came out with these
super cool, like, brightly colored tufts, and I think they would look really cool on perhaps some of this Lumineth Realm Lord stuff, but also on
identity, like as coral or anemones or something. So I really want to get those. Plus, I want to get more color shifts. On my void dragon, and it looks so cool, and I really want to get more. Like, for example, for the Luminous,
they have sun metal weapons. I think it would be cool to get like a yellow to orange, like a goldish yellow to orange. That would look really cool for all the weapons. Probably show that on the... I'll show my work in progress when I make this Queen Stuff World hall, I guess. Okay. Also love the little Scorpec Lord. Awesome. And the kind of debris reminds me I did get some leaves from that order as well. Thinking of my Sylvaneth. Okay. Speaking of Sylvaneth. Just casually having a look through. I do love a nice map. Oh, here's a space map. That's pretty cool. This just reminded me of Detroit Become Human. Connor, best character. Ooh, here's a nice guys, some Admech V Death Guard. I'm just like craning my neck to see this. We have, my husband and I have a game in progress.
Our fully painted Necrons versus Admech game with painted terrain. Still mid game. We kind of like got super tired during it and we haven't gotten to get back.
Oh geez, I just thought of something. I usually film upstairs, but since that game is still in progress, I'm filming downstairs and the clock is ticking. And I know that annoys some people.
So if you don't mind, I'm gonna stand up for a second and go take the battery out. I'll be right back.
Okay, so we have some more stuff about the Caradon sector. It's been going on for quite a while in the White Dwarf. This is a pretty cool piece of art. The worlds in the Caradon sector are many and varied, ranging from the Forge world of Metallica and its many manufactorum worlds,
to hive planets, mining colonies, a space marine chapter, homeworld, and even an ocean planet. All provide great inspiration for your army. Look at these tentacles. Oh my. And here.
More Death Guard. It's one of those pictures where you kind of can't tell what's going on completely because it's like too many, it's a little too busy, you know what I'm saying? A little too densely packed. Like you've got the little plague bear. Those are some drones, blow drones, right?
Oh gosh, I don't know the name of everything. I'm sorry. I really hope my hair is not annoying. I know you can't see it, but you can hear it. At least if the microphones are picking it up.
Light Lord Terminators. I like the bright style they went for. That's kind of acting like a tractor or like a big piece of machinery. I kind of like that. It's not just a tank, you know? It's like, it's doing a job. Other than killing stuff. It's kind of a cool idea. A fuel trailer. I like it. Some ghostly looking. Remind me like of the Army of the Dead from the Lord of the Rings. Very cool. I'd like to get into mine before too long as well. I have a lot of armies, let's just say. I'm working on Necrons right now, but I also have, let's see, Space Wolves, Thousand Sons, Sisters of Battle. Scheme on some sisters. Very cool. Created Order of the Cleansing Tide. Awesome. Some Death Shroud Terminators.
Interesting. Okay, we've got our painting splatter, paint splatter. Caradon. I've got a mission here. A fell tide.
Let's read the briefing. Typhus's orbital bombardments of the Caradon sector unleashed deadly warp-borne contagions. On the wave-tossed world of Fathom, the defenders managed to intercept many of the Death Guard's disease-laced munitions.
Debris splinters made it to the surface, lodged in the superstructures of huge extraction rigs. Vicious battles over the control of these infectious fragments were fought as the tumultuous seas
battered the gantries. And let's see. So you're controlling objectives. The objectives would be those contagious shards, most likely. Looks like a pretty standard deployment zone.
I like these orbs. I always look at the terrain. I know I'm kind of a weirdo like that. I like terrain.
And here's that crusade info for the tomb keepers that they mentioned in the letters section. Sorry, my throat is kind of dry. Ooh, a name generator. I forgot to bring some dice over, but we can take a little look. Let's just and then wherever my chopstick is, I will stop and we'll make that be our first name.
So I love these name generators. They're so cool and they're fun to roll on. I wish they would do this for all the different boards.
pricing they would do that for the Tome Keepers here. Okay, let's stop.
Of reading very much from any one thing, simply because of the IP stuff, but we're just browsing. I'm not trying to read the whole thing to you. Okay. I'm mostly just looking at pictures and stuff.
Looking at this reminds me new dragons. What do you guys think of those? I love them, especially the ones that look kind of like, I don't know, classic 80s, 90s, like, cartoon dragons. The one that looks kind of smiley, the blue one.
I love those. I think I need at least one at some point. Ooh, look at this loot boss. Checkered pattern on the top half of the face.
Looking at these mushrooms, I like that they painted them like they were different species. Very nice.
How they get the effect so nice on the artwork.
Oh, look at those squigs. They look vicious.
I love the eyes.
I'm pro goofiness. Nations is a very underused word, but it does get its fair play in Games Workshop products. Machinations, machinations, machinations. Machinations.
days of each other.
I don't remember the reason, but I know these two issues got held up for the U.S.
Maybe all of North America. I can't quite recall. Okay, they've been doing this a lot. This is a nice thick page that they do with some kind of cards that you can cut out and use. This time we have
what they do for these, and we have Glottor Bulk and Durko Walrus Spider.
I like that guy, by the way. I think it would be cool to have one of the behemoth guys with my identity get put in. So there you have it. Rules for you to try out on the battlefield,
plus new stories and background about the setting, giving you plenty of opportunities to theme your games. You could recreate some of the battles mentioned in the background,
convert characters based on the heroes in the stories, or build a new battlefield to represent one of the regions.
The death cabbage around these parts. My husband has one, but he has not painted it yet. Okay, so we've got a couple of battle plans here. Holding the breach and
betrayal at the wall. Oh, even more. Fire at the docks. The secrets of Excelsis.
We have more info here. This reminds me of, like, early Warhammer rulebook art. Boy, that spike looks very painful. So they've been doing this kind of, what would I call it? Army buildup, I guess. Escalation. They alternate months with Age of Sigmar and 40k. So this month was Age of Sigmar. If you're actually going to play a game at 750 is like the low point, but they might have started with 500 points just to paint up. They are building and painting in segments.
So here, than Lion has so far. There he is up there. So he has a Cavalar, Avalonor, so that's the character. Stone Cow? Mountain Cow.
Of course, to go with him, we have some Stone Guard. That's the guys with the helmets with a cow head on top. We have some Warden. The spear guys, and he took a rune, kind of like to add to a weapon. And, oh, sorry, that's an endless spell. My bad, I apologize. Okay, so here we have the segments model. So he painted up the Stone Guard and Apple. Something else in there that I'm missing. Love the color scheme, it looks really pretty. I've only played one game with my Lumineth. I have the non-character version of this big mountain cow.
And mine died very quickly. It has fewer wounds than you would expect it to. But it was also the case of like, my husband was, he's my about that model, so he kind of keyed up on it a little bit with his stuff.
He was playing Gloomspite Gets, and he ended up, I can't remember, I think he won, pretty sure. He had a whole bunch of trolls, and they were a big pain in my butt. Chaos Army here.
Which exact variant was that?
Slaves to Darkness. I forget what they're called sometimes. Okay.
So the Spirinx, the Chariots, Knights, Warriors, and a Chaos Lord on Garkadrick.
So this time, looks like Miyuki folks. Chariots and Spearings.
Very cool. I like the snowy theme. Very nice. Okay, next.
Yeah, this has got to be Cities of Sigmar. Let's see, Hallowstone Hole. Stuff here. We have an anointed, a sorceress,
two phoenix card. We have some black cards and dark shards. I'm confused about that. Maybe it's just dark shards. We have Sisters of the Watch and tree revenants.
I love the tree guys. Also, I love the Sisters of the Watch. They're really cool. These are very brightly colored. Very cool. It looks like Sisters of the Watch back there. So a lot of small models this month. I like it. Very nice. And last one was Edenites of Slana.
Is bigger than Painbringers and Fiends. So it looks like we got Painbringers this time. I think that's what these guys are. Yes, Painbringers and Lord of Pain. It's gonna be that guy. Perhaps a little too much pain? That he has painted and won for over the years. Let's see. Gold in 2011 at the first cut.
I definitely respect people who can make a cool diorama. Looks like he has a distinct style too. Do you like plinth? We have an eye for an eye or fatal extraction, which also won a gold award. Very cool. Definitely feel
like the movement on this one. Okay, also in 2013 for a gold award, Ogre Hunter. So this must be diorama. Duel, maybe. Duel. And this is a monster.
They're definitely very, very professional. I don't go for Golden Demon quality. I'll never get there, but
I just go for what I think looks good. So near and yet so. 2016. I like the jungle theme.
Crotch from 2017. I like the weathering. Very cool. And the effect.
Daughter is he painted these. Oh wait. That's his daughter's and this is his son's. So the skill in painting seems to run in the family.
Here we have a silver from 2018.
Crimson Court. My husband has those. And he also has these. Head Cracker's Mob. These were very effective.
I played them versus the Warband. I think how these Underworlds articles show you, like, I think all or most of the cards. So you can get the feel for how they play.
And what kind of tactics you would want to use. synergies and that sort of thing.
Ooh, this one might be controversial. With Cursed City kind of being a thorn in some people's side, since it was so hard to come by. We did get one. We haven't played the game yet, but the models, I think, are all put together.
They are very beautiful. Not everybody likes these. I think you can buy these on their own. Already. Everybody likes the, like, bent-over snail kind of aspect. I think it's a cool idea. Maybe they shouldn't all have that.
But, I get it. They're trying to, like, keep them down. So they're kind of like, they don't want the dead to rise. So they've tried to keep them in the earth.
So this is how those people with the stuff pierced into their back and head are able to come up out of the ground. He's digging them. The Virgos Bloodborne kind of gargoyle-esque ladies and gentlemen.
Creepy, like a bat werewolf.
These guys look very Mongolian to me. I do like them. I think they're cool. Yeah, Vergilius Redicar and the wolf. You can get the beast as well. There are more models from that set.
What's this? Black library. Reading guide for Ageofsigmar. Okay. Let's see. A great first read would be The Realm Gate Wars. Okay, volume 1. And then moving on to Plague Garden.
Then Realm Gate Wars. Then it's saying Spear of Shadows. Then the Iron Dragon.
Then Black Talon, First Mark. Hamilcar, Champion of the Gods. And
Callus and Tol, the Silver Shard. I'll be honest, I do love the lore, but I have some digital books and even audiobooks. Gone through them.
Okay, this one is talking about the Soul Wars. Looks like you got a couple options for a first read. There's so many cool things to read. Where could you ever find all the time to keep up on all aspects of this deliciously fun
hobby? And this is just Games Workshop stuff. I mean, there's so many other cool companies, cool games, cool models, and cool lore. My eye was captured by the Realm Wars. Creepy. fingers here. Oops, sorry. Quick beam. I'm not sure who this is. I like him.
Long story, the white bearded ancestor.
Some nice dwarven lore.
Feature
of the issue we have. Ooh, look at that. I always like seeing alternate color schemes.
There's the priest up again. Here's what the whole poster looked like. If you couldn't get a good idea from what I showed you. That's cool. See, that's like the crusade. Sell it, but it came out when this current edition stuff came out.
And he made it into like a tome keeper's journal, it looks like. Little Funko.
Maybe
I'll still make it full by the end of the year.
And that's gonna do it for this issue, which was 465. Very soon with the, we'll call it a green stuff world
hobby haul. And take a look at some of the stuff that we've done with the materials already. I hope that this has been somewhat relaxing for you, and
really, really, really hope that the binaural effect has succeeded. I think it will.
Promise this time on Gary's head that I will have another video up for you within the next 1 to 2 days, because I'm gonna film it right now. Alright, you have a wonderful morning, afternoon, evening, or night.